Hi, my name is TZ and I'll be introducing you to the bulk properties of an anteater. So, to give you a good idea of what makes an anteater so special, you'll need to know some background information first. Giant anteaters live throughout Central and Southern America. They're often found in dry tropical forests, grasslands, and savannas, where their food source is abundant. Anteaters primarily feast on ants, as the name suggests, and termites. Their oddly shaped bodies are strategically designed for eating these types of insects. They possess long claws which help them plow through mounds of termite nests. Although anteaters have no teeth, they have long tongues covered in a layer of sticky saliva which flicks up to 150 times per minute and helps them suck up more than 35,000 ants and termites per day. So, why is the anteater so important in the local ecosystem? Well, the anteater plays a vital role in maintaining insect populations. In addition, they also act as prey for other larger carnivores. Without anteaters, the ecosystem would become unbalanced, thus causing it to cripple. But what bulk properties does the anteater use to its advantage? The anteater's swiftness in consuming large amounts of insects is largely due to the viscosity of its saliva. In case you are unfamiliar with this term, viscosity generally means the resistance of a fluid, liquid, or gas to change in shape or movement. Higher viscosity means stronger intermolecular forces, as the molecules are bonded together more tightly, thus making the fluid more resistant to deformation. The anteater takes advantage of this thick saliva and uses it as a lubricant for its long tongue while also allowing insects to stick to it. But how does this relate to intermolecular forces? The anteater's saliva is mainly composed of water, proteins, and organic substances. Since saliva is 99% water, we will be primarily focusing on its intermolecular forces. H2O, which makes up water, is what is known as a polar covalent molecule. This is because the electronegativity of oxygen overcomes the electronegativity of hydrogen, therefore pulling more electrons towards oxygen, making that side more negative and the opposite side more positive. This creates two poles as one side is positive and the other side is negative. Therefore, H2O is a polar covalent molecule. Because H2O is a polar covalent molecule, it exhibits dipole-dipole attractions, which include hydrogen bonds and London dispersion forces. London dispersion forces are the weakest form of dipole-dipole attractions. They're found in all types of atoms and molecules. London dispersion forces are mainly formed due to an uneven distribution of electrons, causing temporary dipoles. Hydrogen bonds are an especially strong form of dipole-dipole attractions. They are formed by the electrostatic attraction between hydrogen and an atom with a relatively high electronegativity, such as oxygen, nitrogen, and fluorine. The hydrogen bonding in water increases its overall intermolecular force, therefore also tightening the bond between H2O molecules. This is proven by water's high boiling point of 100 degrees Celsius. Because the liquid is only able to flow if the molecules are able to pass one another with minimal resistance, stronger intermolecular forces make it difficult for them to flow, also increasing the viscosity. Therefore, water, along with other substances found in saliva, work together to form thick saliva, which benefits anteaters. So, how is viscosity affected by rising temperatures? The viscosity of a liquid will severely decrease as temperature increases. For example, the viscosities of water at 27 degrees Celsius and at 77 degrees Celsius are 0.85 times 10 to the negative third and 0.36 times 10 to the negative third pascals per second, respectively. The viscosities of water significantly drops as temperature rises as the molecules are being charged with more kinetic energy because of the heat, which allows the molecules to break the bonds and overcome the intermolecular forces, causing them to spread out more, consequently allowing the molecules to flow more easily as they can pass by each other with minimal resistance. As you know, global warming is a major topic affecting everyone. So what would happen to the anteater and its ecosystem as a result of global warming? Global warming will cause the already vulnerable anteater to go completely extinct. This is because as temperatures rise, the intermolecular forces within the saliva will become less attractive, therefore decreasing the viscosity. This will affect the anteater as its saliva will become less sticky and will also become less effective as a lubricant for its tongue. This will cause the anteaters to starve as they will consume fewer termites and ants, therefore unbalancing the ecosystem. Termites will also increase in quantity when the climate becomes warmer. Therefore, fewer anteaters and more termites will only cause detrimental effects to the ecosystem, further unbalancing it. The anteater is an incredible animal that takes advantage of bulk properties. Its unique body design and saliva have allowed it to utilize viscosity to the fullest potential, thus also allowing it to have maximum efficiency when consuming insects. I hope you have enjoyed learning about how intermolecular forces relate to bulk properties and also the effects on the ecosystem due to global warming. Thank you for watching my video, and I hope you have a good day.